take that sort of attitude with me. I've already told you, sir. I do what I can when I can.
Oh, well, sir.
What is it?
Her husband's turned up. He wants to have a word with her.
Okay. Lindsay, your husband's here.
I didn't ask you to bring him here.
Look, Mrs. Hewitt, he's come in of his own accord. He said he's been worried about you.
I'd prefer not to see him right now.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Well, I suppose I ought to let him know what's happened.
I suppose you can't understand that.
It's up to you, Lindsay.
Thing is, he won't believe it. He just won't believe
it. He's a bit wound up. Mr. Hewitt?
Yeah?
Where's your wife?
Come in here, please.
What's going on? Is Lindsay all right?
She's a bit shaken up.
Shaken up?
She's okay. She's with the WPC at the moment.
I don't understand. What's she doing here? She didn't try anything silly, did she?
How do you mean?
Well, we had a row this morning, just stormed out the house. I let her go. I started to worry that she might, you know.
Try to harm herself? Was the row that serious?
Not really, but the frame of mind she's been in recently, it's nervous breakdown waiting to happen. I've been driving around looking for her. I'm supposed to be at work. So why is she here?
She said that two men tried to force her into their car.
Said what?
Tried to abduct her.
What two men?
She'd never seen them before.
Two strange men tried to abduct her in broad daylight.
It's been known to happen.
I don't know if she told you. She was a rape victim last year.
I don't want to spend the rest of my life in fear of men. That's why when those two men called me over to their car asking directions, I forced myself to go over to them.
You're sure there were two of them?
Well, of course I'm sure.
One behind the wheel.
And the other in the back. He was the one who opened the door and grabbed me. But I managed to pull free and I kicked the door as hard as I could in his face.
Did you do any damage to the door?
I must have. I kicked it as hard as I could, but I didn't stop to check. I ran.
What's your impression of her?
Well, she seems very lucid to me, sir. And the marks on her arm are real enough.
So, you're inclined to believe her. What sort of description has she given us?
Well, the vehicle, a maroon J-Reg BMW, has some damage to the rear door on the passenger side. Of the occupant, she didn't get a very good look at the driver, but the man that tried to grab her, she described as white, male, in his 20s, dark-haired, smartly dressed.
I'm not saying that she's lying. Well, just it might have been, well, a genuine misunderstanding, that's all.
Misunderstanding? How do you make that out?
Well, look, blokes have to be very careful how they approach women these days. It's all about different perspectives.
What are you on about?
Look, Jim, so I'm walking in the park one day, right? Yeah, I take in the sunshine, yeah, either. And I go and sit at a park bench, right? And there's a woman already sitting there, yeah? Now, from my perspective, it's just somewhere to sit. And from hers, I'm some dodgy bloke she's got to be wary of.
Your case, Red, should have a point.
Look, it's misunderstandings, you see? It's happening all the time. I tell you, it's not easy being a man these days.
What would you know about being a man, Reg?
It's all a big laugh, isn't it, lads?
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. I just don't think it's a humorous topic, that's all.
See what I mean? Different perspectives.
Sierra Oscar from 469, receiving over.
Go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, that BMW we were asked to look out for. I think I've found it. It's parked outside the King's Head in Hoxton Road.
Well, we've run a PNC check. The registered owner is a Peter George Ross in Epping. We've rung the station, but they haven't come back to us yet.
Look, why are you telling me all this? I mean, even if it's the right car, we can't be sure a crime's been committed.
If what Lindsay Hewitt says squares up.
If.
And if they tried it with her, they might have tried it with other women.
Well, as you can see, I've got loads of people sitting around here playing noughts and crosses. We've got enough confirmed crimes to be getting on with.
And I've got three officers off sick. This one needs to be checked out, Frank.
Lindsay Hewitt described, all right. It's them.
Do you need me?
No, we'll talk.
She said confidently.
Give us my
Yes, ma'am. Same again, when you're ready, please.
Would you like a proper drink?
I'm all right, thanks.
I can see you're all right. You're definitely all right. But would you like a drink?
Not at lunchtime. It makes me go all stupid.
Well, that's the idea. I mean, you want to be sensible all the time.
I hope you're not driving.
He does the driving and he's on orange juice, like you. We could take you for a spin if you want.
You've got a car? I just thought you'd have a skateboard, a young chap like you. What sort of car?
BMW.
We'll come back when you've got a Porsche. In the meantime, it's my lunch break, and I'd like to finish my sandwich, so...
Oh, shove the office. We're taking the afternoon off. There's this club I'm a member of. The Alhambra, Lansdowne Road, you know it?
No, I don't frequent afternoon clubs.
Shame. You'd have had an experience you'd never forget. I'll catch you another time, maybe.
Hang about. Where did you say this club was?
Lansdowne Road. Only 5 minutes. In the car. Go on. Be naughty.
I've just got to make a phone call first.
Who to?
The office. I've just gone down with a migraine.
What's happening?
They want me to go to some club with them, the Alhambra in Lansdowne Road.
Right, let's pull them in.
I'm going with them.
I don't be daft.
Let's see what happens.
Joe, get real. What if they're planning something?
Then they're in for a nasty surprise.
Look, we've already got someone to point the finger, Lindsay Hewitt.
The moment it's only her word against theirs. And you know how much that will count for in court. It's heaven sent. Just make sure you're in the vicinity.
Joe! Joe!
The owner's only just reported it missing.
Never mind that. Where's Carver?
Following closely, I trust. I've asked Uniform to keep backup handy.
We'll make sure it is. What's Morgan playing now, Frank?
I don't know. I only hope she does.
We're still on Goddard Street, heading east.
The other one's been informed, Jim.
Damn! Take a right down here. They're taking a right into Waterman's Road. That's a road that skirts Sea Coal Yard warehouses.
That's the opposite direction to Lansdowne Road.
I think we can forget about Lansdowne Road. Damn!
This isn't the way.
We're taking the scenic route. I don't believe this. Oi! Oi! Move that, will ya?
Yeah. Oscar from DC Carver, receiving, over.
Go ahead, Jim.
Look, I've lost him, but they should still be on Waterman's Road.
They'll meet 01 coming the other way, then.
What's going on?
Relax.
Why are we going down here?
Stop the car, now.
Shut it.
What?
I said shut it.
Sir Oscar from 01 receiving, over.
Go ahead, Barry.
We're heading north on Waterman's Road. No sign of the BMW. We should have seen him by now.
They must have veered off. There's some old warehouses around there. Tell them to get down there quick.
Right, Gov.
01 from Sierra Oscar.
No, not here. It's too open. There, turn right down there.
They could be anywhere amongst this lot.
I told you to pull up. I want to get out.
Here will do. Good a place as any.
Come here! Well, don't just stand there! Off against the car!
All right. Take it easy. What's the problem?
Your problems are just beginning. You're under arrest for abduction.
Attempted abduction, Sarge. It's the bloke took Joe Morgan for a spin.
Oh, yes. Well. Name?
Dean. Stacy. I'd like my solicitor informed, please.
All in good time. Address?
32 Melville Gardens, Harlow.
Date of birth?
I believe I am entitled to have my solicitor here.
First things first, date of birth.
17th, 3rd, 72.
Right, turn your pockets out.
Believe me, Sergeant, I really do want to cooperate, but I must tell you, you're making a serious error.
You should be able to help us sort this out.
Apex School of Business Studies, Harlow.
You're a student.
I'm the victim of a wrongful arrest. I want my old man informed. He'll sort this out. Mark my words. Heads are gonna roll. And yours. Yours will be the first into the basket.
What's happening with the other one?
Still at the hospital. A concussion, according to Loxton, but he'll live.
Pity.
His name's Tony Franklin, and he's got previous for indecent assault. He was only released from prison 3 weeks ago.
Oh, another one successfully rehabilitated. What about Stacy?
There's nothing on him.
There will be by the time I finish with him.
So what happened to you?
Well, there's this stupid woman.
Oh, yes, stupid woman.
Joe, my office. What do you think you were doing getting into that car?
I had to make a snap decision, sir.
You mean you were playing cowboys? You should have brought them in straight off. They were driving a stolen car, for God's sake.
I didn't know that. We had nothing else on them. My judgment was to go with it a bit further.
Look, I don't know how you went on at your last place, Joe, but here we believe in teamwork.
Well, so do I, sir. That's why I put Jim Carver in the picture.
You mean you put him in a spot? And you put yourself at risk?
It's part of the job, isn't it?
Necessary risks are part of the job. This was unnecessary and unacceptable. You know what could have happened to you, don't you?
But now they're in the bag and there's no chance they can talk their way out of it.
Isn't there? I wish I shared your optimism. You're still settling in, Joe, so I'm not going to make a big fuss. But just file this away for future reference. Teamwork, not heroics.
Is she saying that I forced her into that car? If she is, she's lying. She got in of her own accord. I never laid a finger on her.
Your pal did, though. Which is hardly surprising, as he's got a record of violence against women.
Mr. Stacey isn't answerable for Franklin's past offences, Detective Inspector.
He's answerable for the latest one.
Mr. Stacey disputes that.
Does he also dispute that Franklin's record makes him undesirable company? Or is he a kindred spirit?
I didn't know he had a record. I only met him in a pub the other night.
Well, he certainly seemed to have built up a good understanding. When you told him to stop the car, didn't you say, this is as good a place as anywhere for it? What did you mean by that?
I just meant that he should stop the car and let her out. I mean, that's what she was asking for. I couldn't believe it when he started hitting her. I got out of the car to stop him.
I find that hard to believe.
It's the truth.
I think you and Franklin had this all planned. I think the intention was to abduct a woman, take her to the warehouse area and force her to have sex.
No.
That's why you stole the car. You didn't dare use your own.
Yes, sir. No.
My name's Ken Stacey. I understand you're holding my son, Dean.
Oh, yes, sir. I don't think you're able to see him at the moment.
It's your chief I'd like to see.
Stacey says he never threatened you. Never touched you.
Well, of course he's saying that.
Well, did he?
Well, no, but only because he never got the chance.
Well, I can see the CPS turning their noses up at that. I mean, they're hardly likely to prosecute on the basis of what he might have done had he had half a chance.
Conspiracy. They were in it together, Gov.
Stacey is putting daylight between himself and Franklin. What's Franklin saying?
By the news from the hospital, he's not even talking to the nurses.
I don't see there's any problem. Lindsay Hewitt will identify them for sure.
It's pretty clear that WDC Morgan was acting as an agent provocateur.
In plain English, she set my son up.
She was investigating a report of an attempted abduction. Now, we had reason to believe that Franklin and your son were involved.
Well, in that case, why weren't they brought in for questioning?
They were brought in for questioning.
Yeah, after Dean Stacey was allowed to unwittingly incriminate himself.
After both men had confirmed Morgan's suspicions. There was nothing unwitting about Franklin's violence.
Yes, but we're talking about my son, not some yobbo at the council estate. Now, Dean's had a proper upbringing. But you know what kids of that age are like. Easily led. This Franklin must have shot him a line.
The fact remains that your son was involved in an incident where a police officer was abducted and assaulted.
Yeah, and whose fault's that?
Look, wouldn't you say that a woman who gets into a motor with two men is telling them something? She's telling them she's game for it. You're going to charge my son with being a normal, red-blooded young man?
She's upstairs. What's it about? We've got two men in custody. We believe that they're the men that tried to abduct Lindsay. And I need to know whether Lindsay would be willing to attend an identity parade.
I see. So she'll have to go through the whole thing again, another court case. She hasn't got over the last one.
It's very important.
Well, my marriage isn't. Husbands are the other victims of rape, you know. Wrecks our lives too.
Look, I can appreciate it's been an ordeal for you, but
the feeling of helplessness? The feeling that I failed her? When was I when it happened?
I'm sure Lindsay doesn't see it that way.
But I do.
You shouldn't, Brian. It wasn't your fault.
He wants you.
I know, I heard.
Is it really necessary?
If we're to make the charge stick.
He's downstairs, Donna.
This'll be of interest to you, Joe. Harlow.
What about it?
You know, Stacey's studying there, and Franklin lives nearby. Well, I checked with Harlow Police.
And?
I found out something interesting.
You were doing a business studies course in Harlow, Mr. Stacey.
That's right.
10 days ago in the Harlow area, a young woman was abducted by two men and subsequently raped. She was then dumped by the roadside.
So? What's that got to do with me?
She gave a good description of the two men. She could have been describing you and Franklin.
In fact, I think she was describing you and Franklin.
No. You're trying it on.
You've always got the things you wanted, haven't you, Dean? Your father saw to that. Shiny toys, lots of pocket money. You think it's the same with women. See one you like, you think she's there for the taking.
You've dredged up some lying cow from somewhere.
Well, fortunately, we don't have to rely on her testimony alone. Do you know what DNA testing is? If you don't, I'm sure Mr. Dawson here can explain it to you.
Right. I'll let her know.
I'll try and talk him round.
At the end of the day, it has to be your decision, not his.
I know. Do you think I'm using him as an excuse to cover up my own cowardice?
No, I don't think you're a coward, Lindsay.
Maybe I am. Because the prospect of having to get up in that witness box. The last time his counsel tried to make out I consented.
Standard defense in rape cases. Sometimes it works.
I ended up thinking I was on trial. So you can see why I'm reluctant.
And yet you reported the attempted abduction. I mean, you took the risk of being disbelieved.
Because
what?
Because it's not just about me, is it? I mean, they might attack other women.
These two men have already committed at least one rape.
What? Why didn't you say?
I only just found out. One of them's making a confession right now.
Does that mean you won't need me after all?
It may still be necessary. I mean, the more evidence we've got against them, the better.
In that case,
I'll be in touch.
Sergeant. Thanks.
For what?
Believing my story. Thousands wouldn't.